Now, I'm absolutely mortified. I haven't seen anything this bad ever.
Are you on time with any of your bills?
No.
We don't have internet anymore. The trash just got paid the other day. The rent hasn't gotten paid this month. The water is a separate bill. Hasn't been paid in a year.
I mean, he's got the books in his head. They have no idea what their annual income is. The utilities aren't being paid. That's ridiculous.
My parents own the building.
And how much is the rent?
I pay $4,500 a month.
For this in LA?
Oh yeah, that's cheap.
This would be like 15 grand.
But guess what? It's hard for me to even pay $4,500. I'm late like a month, maybe two sometimes.
Did they ever threaten to evict you?
I got an eviction notice, believe it or not.
From your parents?
From their attorney.
Wow.
That's trash.
I'm almost here.
Need all this.
You gotta be kidding me. So I've been giving John a lot of leeway lately, because I don't want to throw away anything that's worth any money. But he's been dragging his ass like he's on vacation and starting to hold up things I have to get done. John, come here.
Here comes Muscle.
Come on. I need to talk to you.
Well, you realize...
No, you need to say nothing until you come over here. So I'm going to put him on notice. Either he needs to pull it together or I'm sending him home and we'll decide what's trash.
You realize every time you and I have a
talk... Stop for a second. You need to stop, close your mouth, and listen for one minute. If somebody came to me and they said, Russ, I need your help, just like you did with Richard, then you got to be able to give on your end. And you're not. The bottom line is that you have got to dig down and you have got... Dude, it's not funny. You know what? John's way more hopeless than I thought. I guess we're gonna do this the hard way. So I need you to get whatever you need to get and get the hell out of our way. So I decided to send John and his guys home a little bit earlier than we had planned.
That guy is a big waste of time.
To say this place is a mess is an understatement. Johnny's got half-built cars tucked away in every crevice. There's no room to move around, and the lift and equipment look like they haven't been touched in ages. Not using that lift alone is about $1,000 a day down the drain. It doesn't look like you have much tools. What's going on over here? Is this the only tools you have?
Well, yeah, nuts and the bolts here. Some of the tools that I let the guys use, that little box over there.
So, how's that door roll down with it being all bashed up like that in the corners?
Okay, honestly, the door doesn't work. It hasn't worked for 7 years.
You don't shut the door?
Nope.
What do you do for security?
Well, I put up the chain right there and a sign that says keep out. and good Lord's been taking care of this place.
They had toolboxes that didn't have tools in them. They have cars undercover, parts that are not labeled, surfboards. It's just chaos.
What's the Armageddon thing here?
Okay, that's my secret life.
Okay.
The Armageddon is a design that I patented. It's a full American supercar that's underway of being built. That's my dream, and I'm working on it.
I'm starting to see what kind of guy Johnny is. He's a little scattered and a dreamer because he's got dreams of building this big car one day and what have you. I get it. Without dreams, I wouldn't have Gas Monkey Garage or my tequila business or my bar and grill. He seems all over the place, but he hasn't lost me yet.
You know, it's early in the morning. I gotta get a jump on this garage. The guys from Got Junk are gonna pull in this morning. We're gonna start to the wall, get the out. I need everything. Hello, let's go. I need everything that's garbage is gonna end up going in the truck. You see, it's already here. It beat you guys here.
Getting up at 6 a.m. is a pain in the...
All right,
come on, let's go. We got a lot of cool vintage pieces out here, so we need to separate those from the junk.
Keep it slow on the bump.
We're the good old boys.
Yeah, baby, surfing cars.
I'm going for a ride.
I really like Johnny, but I got to keep him in line if we're going to turn this garage around. Stop standing on the hood like an idiot.
Okay, coming down.
He gets a 9 all across from the judges.
So tell me about the books. What's going on here?
Well, I guess to put it bluntly, I don't know what I'm doing with them. I'm a really good car guy, but I'm not much good at the books. The numbers kind of befuddle me. I really don't know what I'm doing.
What are you making yourself? What are you taking home?
I don't even know what that figure is. I take home whatever's left after the bills are paid. Sometimes the bills aren't paid, though.
That's a problem. So I asked John about the finances, and he basically tells me he doesn't know because he's not very good at it, and I don't know if I believe in John as a businessman. where do you stand right now as far as bills and people you owe, and how much is it?
I've got a bill with one of my parts vendors. It's about $6,000. I owe a friend of mine about $5,000 that I borrowed from her a year ago and haven't paid back yet. Other than that, my bills, generally speaking, are about 30 days behind on just about everything.
You got any money in the bank?
No.
All right, man, this is a tough one. Give us a few minutes to talk about it. Go inside.
Guys,
thank you very much.
We'll figure it out.
If Richard doesn't come out to help me, I have everything to lose. This place is my lifeline. This is what I do to support my family.
I think you got the right spot, but you need just about everything. I mean, everything. You don't have a ton of stuff that it needs to turn this around. What I'm looking at, I think you need to spend $125,000.
That's a lot of money. So Richard comes in with this deal for me. It's $125,000. Help me get this place up and running better than it is. Can we talk about pressure?
Here's how it works. I'll spend $125,000 of my time, money, and contacts, but it's my way starting now. Everything, no matter what. It basically will become my shop, and that means you'd be having a boss.
Working for somebody.
Kind of scared to put my garage on the line for this, but I think Richard is exactly what we need to get to the next level.
So that's the deal. You ready?
Yeah, man, I'm, please help me.
All right, well, you're putting a monkey on your back. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, man, I need a monkey on my back for a while. Make this happen.
All right.
Thank you very much, Richard.
Don't say that yet, because the hard part's coming. Y'all get your stuff rounded up?
Yeah, get to it.
I will throw it all away if it's not tied down.
Basically, everything that I've devoted my life to for the past few years, I've just gambled right now.
Hey, John, is that your girlfriend?
No, it's somebody else.
Car coming out.
Hi, I'm Russell.
Hey, Russell, I'm Cheryl Morgan.
Hi, Cheryl.
So in the middle of everything that's going on, moving cars, this and that, this big fancy car pulls up with a man with a camera and a woman gets out. She hands me a bunch of paperwork.
I have that from him giving me access to this lift, which he owes me over $5,000 worth.
Really?
Yes.
What do I find out? John owes her money. She's here to repo some of the equipment.
This lift is mine.
Yep.
And I'm not trying to repossess it today.
Yeah,
I'm just trying to make sure you guys don't take it.
You know, John had mentioned initially when we were talking to him about the financials, he owed some woman $5,000. He made it like it was no big deal. We come to find out she's there to take pictures of his equipment because she's got a court order to take this stuff because he hasn't paid his money. This is obviously a huge deal. At this point, I'm going to have to take this up with Richard because this is beyond my area expertise.
How's it going?
Oh, you tell me.
What is it?
So, remember he mentioned just nonchalantly that he owed somebody $5,000?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, this woman came to repossess the lift as collateral. She was told by the judge that she could come in, repossess that, sell it for whatever she can get for it, and then go after him for the balance of it. He's giving her $500 towards this loan. No communication, ignoring.
Why don't I know this stuff before I get into business with people?
Exactly. So, when we asked
for full disclosure, he said he owed a friend $5,000.
No,
this is not a friend.
Oh, no. Full disclosure is not being had.
So let's go talk to him.
He's over this way.
It's super critical to stay on schedule, and we may lose the rest of the day, but until I know exactly what I'm dealing with a little bit better than I do right now, we're stopping.
John!
Yeah!
Because it might be time to just give up. I'll put his two old crappy lifts up and leave. What in the heck is this? You said you owed a friend $5,000, and this is not a friend.
Well, it was the money that I owed her, and she sued me for it. We did go to court over it. I thought that it had been settled the first time around because the case was dismissed, but then she re-sued, went back to court. My lawyer said
that... Well, you know, if you lose in court, then you got to pay her court fees, too, and her lawyer fees.
Yes.
So this $5,000 could be 10 or 12 or 15.
I sure hope not.
If I'd have known these things and if I'd have known how bad things really were, there's no way I would have invested here. I mean, I'm always a handshake guy. I'm from Texas. I believe it when people tell me something, and this guy flat out lied to me.